we begin monitoring the ponds, it's really important to understand that we're not trying to ask a specific research question. We're really just looking at how the ponds are doing. We're checking in and getting the information to improve our ability to manage those systems. So we use this little inflatable raft. We get out on the water and we make sure that we take some water samples that we send to the lab. These will tell us things like how much nutrients are in the water, if there's salt in the water, how much sediment's in the water. We take succhi depth readings. These help tell us how clear the water is, dissolved oxygen and temperature. And of course, our viewing scope to look at submerged aquatic vegetation. So with that, we head on down and get ourselves some samples. These waters are really important for the city of Bloomington because they serve as a refuge for wildlife, aesthetics for local residents, and they help process and clean our stormwater as it flows in from the city. Without them, and without proper management, we could lose some quality ecosystem characteristics that we take for granted. So this management helps us make a decision of how we can make the water cleaner, how we can improve habitat, and for the life that's living in the ponds. Monitoring is only one small piece of the management puzzle. Bodies of water, like lakes and ponds, are really complex systems, and they have a lot to tell us. When we go out and collect information on the water, we're looking for a snapshot in time. Basically, what does that water look like on the day of sampling? And we do this in Bloomington once a month, usually the first full week of every month, starting from spring to fall. And over time, we start to collect this information and we can start to get averages. And that can tell us characteristics of that particular water body. We can see how deep it is, how clear the water is, if there's any big influxes of nutrients, or how good the vegetation community is. And that can start to tell us how that body of water functions. And when we can see how it functions, we can start to make decisions on what's best for the community around that water. And that community can include fish, it can include insects, it can include birds, and of course, it includes people. So my job as the water resources specialist is to go out and collect those measurements and then analyze them and start making really good management decisions. It's pretty fun going on a little boat, but it's pretty serious work. One of the first things the city does when we come out here is we take water clarity. We look at how the vegetation looks in the water. We look at how much duckweed is floating on the surface. And we also take water samples. The water samples are sent to a lab and those look at phosphorus, chlorides, conductivity, total suspended solids. Each one of those parameters tells us something different about how the water's acting, what's coming into it, and how is it processing as it moves through the water body. Most of the ponds in Bloomington are stormwater ponds. And that means that the water that flows down the roads, off the parking lots, down your sidewalk, goes right into your storm drains and out into a pond. All the dirt, all the salt, all the pollution that is in that water as it washes off that concrete ends up in the ponds. And that's really stressful for these pieces of water. And that's why we have to make sure that we do things as a city to improve our management and make sure that the water is cleaner in the long run.
There are many management strategies used to improve or rehabilitate parts of a pond. However, none of them are perfect, and usually a successful restoration includes some combination of management options. The information gathered during sampling provides the information we need to choose which of these management options or combination of options is best.
Monitoring and evaluating pond ecosystems is only one piece of the puzzle in improving their management. We all have to do our part, keep water clean, respect habitat, and understand that all of our decisions have an impact in the future.